What's up, y'all? Welcome to Make It Songbringer. Day 413. Development day 413. Non-consecutive day 413. So yeah, I'm starting the Fear Dungeon. So this is the boss from the sand or acid pyramid, whatever you want to call it. Anyways, I'm gonna go and start off the game somewhere else. A new dungeon. New dungeon this week. New dungeon every week until the dungeons are done. So I need, the first thing I need is a style. I gotta get, whenever I close Xcode, I lose my whole setup here for my assistant view. Oh, let's get that back how it's supposed to be here. Strings. Close, Xcode, reload. Rocket Bunny, what's up, man? Congrats on learning what you learned with the buffer. Did you learn something? With the car buffer, the character buffer? Strings, story. Yep. Right on. So tell me what you learned. Now that you've had a moment to think about it, what was it that you learned from that? Let's see, world. World and these foes. Yeah, world. Entities. I'm trying to have the same exact set up every time, so it's very easy to remember. It becomes muscle memory. Muscle memory. Thank you, muscle memory. Should put that down to 30 FPS. What's up, Pedro? Howdy. I just realized you could type hey guts. What's up, Red Sands? Thanks, man. You learned that strings are really weird in C. Oh man. I know you got something else you can learn from this, man. I know you can. There's one more little thing you can learn. What stage are we at? Well, what stage are we at? Last night I published the new update to Steam. So the Sand Pyramid dungeon is up, part of the Murmuroth update. So that's all said and done. Got my marketing done last night. It took a while, actually, to get to this version out. As always, there's always problems whenever I go and try and compile on Windows. Microsoft Visual C++ always does things a little differently, like with maps and vectors and iterators and comparators and all that kind of stuff. So there's always problems. There's always problems when I go and compile on Windows. So that took me like 2 hours extra last night. But I'm just complaining. You finally had a job interview with the company you wanted? Oh, that's great. That's great. Yes, it is the sand dungeon, right, Red Sands? It's yellow sand, though. God. Should we make a red sand version? So today I'm starting on the fear dungeon. Totally new dungeon. The boss for this dungeon is going to be pretty cool. Totally inspired by Final Fantasy. Where should I start with this? Where should I start? Yes! Yay, Rocket Bunny! Yay! I'm glad you learned this. Rocket Bunny and I, Rocket Bunny will tweet me like certain questions and stuff about C or C++, and I'll write him back. You learned! Good job, Rocket Bunny! Yeah, Pedro, it already does this. It already does this for the poison boss. There's a shadow on the ground and it gets bigger as he approaches it. What's up, Pro Tito? Okay, so yeah, right. I need to start with world and having a new dungeon type. The dungeon fear. Fear dungeon. Okay, so this shape of this dungeon, I guess for now it's going to be random. Flood! What's up, Flood? No way! How's it going, man? Makefiles are, aren't they? Makefiles are sweet. Cinderella? Yeah. Style character. What was the style character going to be for this one? I've already got 5, 6, 7. This one, I guess, should be either 8 or 9. I always thought this would be dungeon style 9. So, okay, this will be dungeon style 9 for sure. Nice. You came back from vacation? Right on. You got some nighttime? Where'd you go on vacation, man? No, this doesn't actually show 418. This is actually a 0. Yeah, it's just that the 0 looks like the 8. See, if I change this to a 0, it looks very much like an 8, but it does look slightly different than an 8. The 8 has the insides taken in a little bit. So that's correct. Crete, right on. Crete's great. Yeah, that's because I custom did it. I did a custom graphic for day 400 because it looks so wrong. But I'm not going to do a custom graphic for 418. It's not that big of a deal. Okay, so number of rooms for the Fear Dungeon. Probably, let's see. Actually, I should probably just copy these more traditional. This dungeon for Fear. Okay, so Fear Dungeon, style character 9. Number of rooms 18 to 37 is all right. Num keys, num puzzles, num secrets. I wonder if we could have more secrets. This would be an interesting thing to try. Added this ability last week for the dungeon to have more secrets. Right on, man. Thanks. Appreciate it. Really? Thanks for saying that. Yeah, I hope it gets better. It's going to get better and better day by day if I just keep on the same route of, you know, iterative improvement. Fog, tiles, outdoor. No constant damage in the Fear Dungeon. Ground. No grass shapes, no puddle shapes, but we do have some tiles. They're going to become 9 ground, though. Okay, now I need to copy all of the assets. Yeah, the bug list is still puffy. It gets shorter every week, and then it gets longer every week. There's this, like, constant... Since I'm still adding stuff to it... I mean, since I'm still adding things to the game, the bug list just gets longer and longer. I had it all the way down to, like, 20 cards, like, a month ago. And then now it's back up to 85 cards. This is just on my now list. You know, if I really focus, I can get about 20 cards done a day. That's like a really good day, though. Like maybe more like 15 cards a day. So for now, since there's so much more content still to be added to the game, I can't really focus on this bug list so much. So the game's going to be kind of buggy, kind of sloppy for the next month or two as I get all of the game finished, all the dungeons finished, all the bosses finished, all the enemies. And then once the game is kind of set, the things will really settle down a bit after that, and then I can kind of focus on bugs. Okay, man, I'll work on that. What's up, Scissor? Just working on the fear dungeon. You burn the bacon? No. Yeah, Trello's great. Trello's pretty great. I was very hesitant to try it because I was just like, I'm over, like, you know, there's things like track. Things, you know, like track is the old one. You still have track? Track's not even a thing anymore. But anyways, you know, when I finally decided to give Trello a go, it actually is really awesome. It's pretty awesome because you can make things kind of visual. You can prioritize things with colors or whatever. People can submit, you know, bugs. So it's public. There's a lot of things about Trello that make it great for game dev. Okay, so got a fear dungeon started here. Now we need assets. What should I start with? Maybe 5. I kind of want to start with 5. Nine entrance. Nine wall door. How do you append a character array to a character pointer, which are the same thing? These are the same thing, man. In C, you use stir. What's it? It's not stir copy. Yeah, you can append an array to an array. C string append. How do you do that? Stir cat. There it is. Stir cat. But you have to have enough space in the first string though. You gotta remember that. Yep, live C. Nine wall. Okay, so I'm getting all the assets in place for the fear dungeon. I'll state my process. My process for developing these new dungeons has been to spend about a 1 week initially creating the dungeon and the boss and some of the more important parts of the dungeon. And then I give it about, you know, a month or whatever of working on other stuff. And then I'll come back to that dungeon and refine it, make it really, really awesome. So that's how I'm going. I'm doing 1 week of, so I'll spend 1 week here creating this an initial fear dungeon, and then later I'll come back to the fear dungeon and make it super tits. Super tits. Super duper tits. Yeah, it's the same thing. You can use memcopy as well. Why is this confusing to you, Rocket Bunny? Are there toys for Songbringer? No, not yet. But I do have an idea of maybe doing like a cloth map or something like that. But maybe there should be toys, huh? I don't know. I'm not exactly a merchandiser. Merchandiser, it makes you think of Spaceballs. But you can maybe swing something like that. Why you ask that? Is there a certain toy you wish there was? Or is there someone that you know that wishes there was a toy for Songbringer? Like a certain character or something? Seems like they should be different. Jib plushie! Jib plushie! Okay, now I've got these PSDs. I'm gonna go and export all these. Oh, really? Oh, Vlad, cool. I did not know that. We finally have shed some light on this. So this is the 9 Waldor ground. Level 9 Waldor ground. The 9 wall. We gotta get this other one too. 9 Waldor. Oh, very good point. This is 9 statue. There's only one of them, so I gotta use this export. Pillar 2, 9 pillar 1, 9 pillar 0, light pillar. Ground tiles, level. That's it. All right. Okay. So I got 9 ground here. We need an entrance as well. Oh, I don't have the entrance exported. Nice. You're playing Doom? The new Doom? Yeah? Oh, yeah. I'm sure you're talking about the new Doom. Really? Well, that's cool to hear. I'm glad they did a good job of it. How does it compare to the old Doom? Like, did they bring any of the same kind of levels or anything, or same items or something to connect it with the old Doom? I'm sure they must have done something like that. happened to nine entrance? Nine entrance. Oh, I just didn't select it. Come on, you're in here too. Come on. Everybody's welcome in Photoshop. Whoops. Oh, damn. I just exported the wrong thing there. How many lines of code are in Songbringer? Let's see. I haven't looked in a minute. 68,000. Nice. I'm glad it's still below 75. It's more complex. You have color keys. Okay, so like the old one, the map is open. Right, so you can't go on top of things anymore, or you can go on top of things now. Some of the monsters the same. Cool. Boogie! What's up, man? Cool, so you collect health, some of the weapons are the same. Alright, cool, so they are tying it in with the old Doom. I just exported some files I definitely don't need. Nine entrance underscore all these blah blah blah. These are unnecessary files. Get rid of thou. Get out of here. Let me re-export this. Just to prove I know how. Gotta click all the user slices. Damn it. Gotta remember that. It's intense. Really? High adrenaline? Wow. Nice. That's the feeling I got when I played Doom as well. Or the old Doom. So I'm glad that they still have that intensity. I also got that feeling with Quake. They're really intense games. Okay, we should have this stuff all set up. I need an entrance. To dungeon 9. Nines all over the place. Okay, so now that I have a style for the Fear Dungeon, I need to put that style to use. Let's make Dungeon 8, maybe Dungeon 7. We've got 1, 3, 4, 6, 3, 7. We'll do 8, yeah. Dungeon 8 is going to be Fear. Maybe Dungeon 9, I don't know. Seven. Dungeon 7's Fear for now. Flood, how's business going, man? Okay, so we've got Dungeon 7 as the Fear Dungeon. If the game can run, then that means it's got all the assets it needs. And if it does run, then I'd like to be inside this new dungeon, which will look exactly like an old dungeon at first. So we'll go to 7. this dungeon style is actually pretty close to what I want this to look like. Well, no, I do want to have a little bit of cool. Yeah, actually, I could live with it looking like this. Dark. I was imagining mostly black. So I'll make, let's say we don't have any wall thickness yet. Fear dungeon wall thickness. I'm thinking of doing a crazy spread, like all the way from 1 to 6. That's crazy. 6 is totally crazy. That's going to be some crazy craziness. Get it ready though. This is looking good. Oh, I need to make these door lights look better. Proton, what's up? What's up? Zeeth, what's up? Dan Brown's Inferno. This not like Dante's Inferno? Oh, the guy that wrote the Da Vinci Code? Cool. Maybe I'll check that out. Dante's Inferno is a good one, too. You probably already know about Dante's Inferno, though. We had to read it in high school, actually. So if I create a door tile, I want style 9 to do some shorty doors. Or style car is 9. Oh, it's about Dante's Inferno? Oh, that makes sense. You have an idea for a small game, but have no idea what you need. I know you have to learn Swift, but what lives your framework? You don't have to necessarily learn Swift. There's lots of game engines that work for iOS. They do not require Swift. Huh, this is like got some water and... This dungeon. Ooh, that's kind of weird. These pillars got lights on top of them. I was thinking this dungeon might actually be entirely dark at first. So you have to go find a switch and turn on the lights. That might be fun. So what I'm doing today is I'm getting things started for the fear dungeon. This is gonna be secret, nice. Just playing around with some like wall fitness styles, art styles and things like that, just to kind of experiment and see what looks good. Like I said earlier, and I do about 1 week of initially creating a dungeon, and then I'll go back later on and do another week of refinement on a dungeon. So I'm just kind of exploring around this dungeon to see what there is. What is there? This is looking good. I'm liking this already. It sort of looks different than most of the other dungeons. It kind of looks similar to the fire dungeon because it's like, I like it though. Maybe it should be changed a little bit though. So. Yeah, Unity Yeah, totally. Coco City X is totally fine for a small game. It's not. It's overkill in the sense, but the only overkill that it really is that it's kind of bloated. So learning it's not too much of an overkill, and using it for a small game is totally not overkill. It's just that there's the thing that's overkill about it is that they put too many features in it already. You know, you don't really need everything in Coco City X anymore. Minimal physics, right on. Unity's overkill? Not necessarily, no. Unity is actually pretty, is a great engine for making games, and it's not overkill because they already have a 2D mode for Unity, and it's a great long-term engine to learn because Unity is so popular now that it probably will never go away. And another great thing about Unity is that it uses an entity component system already. So you're automatically using a very good system for developing your games. So I would recommend it. See, maybe darker. Oh, yeah? Yeah. Ooh, the radius could pulsate? Oh, then that's an interesting idea. Wow, cool. Nice suggestion. Let's try that right now. I'm gonna go to the render system and go to the lights. I think this is at the very end here. These are other lights. I think I wanna do the main light. Not every game needs an entity component system. That's true. Yeah, man. Proton, really, in the end, it kind of depends on what you want for your game and stuff, and I would highly recommend trying out a bunch of game engines. At this point, you have an idea for a game, but you don't have, what you don't have right now is the experience with engines. So try them out. Try a few out. Go get Unity. Try it out for a week. Go get Coco City X. Try it out for a week. Or not necessarily a week. Maybe like just an hour or whatever it takes for you to kind of get the feel for that engine. You know? Yeah, yeah. Let's see what this looks like. Okay, so it's where is it? Is it level? No, it's primary scale. That's right. Primary scale, I think, is a variable. Oh, primary strength. That's it. So dark rooms, do we have the area? We do have the area. All right, cool. Flicker the light in the fear dungeon. So if world has, wait, what's the style car? World get style car. Okay. Okay, I'm going to try and flicker it every single frame at first, but there's lots of things I can do to slow the math down and make it look like it's pulsing slower or faster or whatever. So first I'm just going to flicker it however the hell, every frame. So primary scale times equals, maybe you can flicker by 20% or 20. Not 20%, but 5%. 5% times the randev. Yeah, Yeah, maybe there could be some floaty particles and stuff. I just saw Stranger Things. Stranger Things was really good, by the way, if anybody hasn't seen Stranger Things. Whoa. 5% is a lot bigger than I thought it would be. Why is it so dark, though? It's not supposed to be this dark. That's weird. Plus equals, not times equals. I'm like, why is it so dark? Yeah, I know, right? Let's get the math right, huh? How about I start with the proper math? Oh my god. Okay, so, oh, dude, this is a really great idea, Zeth. This is probably flickering, you know, a little bit too fast right here at first, but it definitely is giving me the feeling of fear, for sure. Flickering light is definitely an excellent idea. Wow. Ah, I love it. I love it. What's it look like in these super dark rooms? Yeah, these super dark rooms, it's even better. Okay, now I'm gonna get it to flicker slower. Rigged. Yeah, I might have to mess with his too. His light's down here below in the same function. Okay, to get it to flicker slower. I could use a static variable or some kind of like flickeriness index or whatever. But I could just use the current tick. As an index into the random numbers. Yeah, I could play with that. I could play with that. I don't want to decrease it too much because that is an item that you buy and you earn. There's three items you get which improve Jib's light. So if you're to, you know, spend all that money or like find all those items on purpose to increase Jib's light and then all of a sudden Jib's light is totally gone or whatever, it kind of wouldn't be that fair, but it might be cool anyways. Who knows? It's cool to mess with the player a bit. Photography, cool. In a C project, is it possible to have two different C files access variables from each other without any headers? Yes. Yes, it is. Yeah, Rocket Bunny, you would do it like this. So in one of your files, you would have your variable or whatever. Static int my variable equals 6 or whatever. And then in your other file, you would go extern static int my variable, and then you'd be able to use it. Maybe you don't need static. I just need extern int or something like that. I don't know. Extern. Extern is the keyword you're thinking of. Senior pictures. Yeah, percent decrease. Yeah. Ooh, that's a good idea too. Making the flicker speed based on the character's health. What is this magic? It's all the magic that us as programmers have put into C over the years. Okay, this is a way to do it without static variables would be to save the DRAM index, set the DRAM index to something deterministic. Like the current tick. Shift it down some. Maybe shift it down too. Then set the DRAM index back to the DRAM save. That should make it flicker slower without using a static variable. You can't get used to auto? I love auto. Yeah, check it out. It's flickering much slower now. That's cool. Huh. Okay, so I'm gonna play around with how fast it should flicker now. Maybe a little slower. Twice as slow, actually. What are you coding in, Zeith? What's your language you use on a daily basis? So that's too slow. What if it's just one? Python? JavaScript? Cool. That's one. Let's shift it down one. Divided by two. I think I liked it about two or three. Yeah, that's about a good pace right there. It's not too flickery. Anywhere between there and one. Actually, let me see one again. What does Malak actually do? It allocates memory. And it allocates it from the heap. It's a big difference between the heap and the stack. Oh, well, not a huge difference. I mean. But it's a difference you should definitely understand. You should understand the difference between heap memory and stack memory. Yeah, okay, so I'm going to flicker Jib's light as well. Const float flicker or something. It is a huge difference. I agree, but like to the new programmer, heapoverflow.com. I have not seen this. What is this? I'm hoping it's not a troll site. Is this all it does? It just loads forever? You randomly made it up? This is the best website ever, man. Look, it is trying to load. It's heap overflowing trying to load. That's why it's taking so long. You randomly made it up. That's boogie. It's boogie for you right there. All right, how to do this right? How to do this the right way? We'll just go float flicker. Float flicker is one. And then flicker is drandif. Right? Come on, somebody's got to. There's got to be like a bufferoverflow.com or something like that. How about stackoverflow.com? We should go reserve that right now. Stack Overflow is a good name for a site, I think. I think I'm going to do something with that. I'm going to go reserve Stack Overflow after the stream. Sounds like a good name for something. Right? Yeah. Right? Who owns this? Who owns this site anyways? What's the command I'm trying to think of? Not trace route. Oh, who is? Who is? Heap overflow. Client delete prohibited. GoDaddy.com registered it. Which tells you nothing about who actually owns it. Nobody knows. It was created in 2005 though. And it's registered all the way to 2021. Somebody like really has a lot of vested interest in this site that doesn't load. Yeah, no, it's all right. You can get it cheap right now? How many assets are in Songbringer? There's a lot of assets. There's a lot. I mean, I don't even know how I would count how many assets there are. And it's also like, do you define whether an asset is a sprite sheet, or you define that the asset is all the little things inside the sprite sheet? Okay, so now I'm going to use that Flickr variable here. And I can go use it for Jibs Light too. Man, great idea about flickering the light. It's such a simple little thing, but it totally says fear. Right away. Genius. Genius, Zeith. Which keeps you warm in the winter. You could totally define it that way. Right? Yeah, that strategy totally works. Something's bound to stick in the wall. It's like how I try to make spaghetti. Okay, which one is Jibs Light? Jibs Light's like, I know one of these is, here it is, Jib. Jibs Light Strength. Stock car is 9. Then we add a little bit to Jibs Light. Wait, I think it's Strength. it's just SL.strength. Plus equals a little bit times the flicker. Is it possible to make a function prototype in a header and then define it in a different C file and then use it in a different... Yeah, of course. That's how headers work. But how do you do it? What do you mean? That's like the basic... That's the basic header thing, man. It's so easy. Yeah, you just... That's all, man. If you're having a problem with it though, send us an example or whatever. We can try and help you out. Maybe if you tried that. Yeah, cool. Jib's light's flickering now too. But are they flickering together? They are, huh? Maybe they shouldn't flicker together. Get two flicker variables. Float flicker. Float flicker two. Flicker two. Yeah, the light's always been off center. It's not off center, it's just that it uses a sine wave to move a little bit differently than the player. Batteries are running low. Jib statically charged. This is fun. I mean, this is already kind of becoming a cool little dungeon. It's already unique in with this whole flickering light thing. Okay, so now they're two independent flickers. Oh, and I think the fire sword is creating some fire, and I think the fire that the fire sword creates also have their own kind of flicker. Yeah, they do. Those fights have flicker as well. Locked door. Are all the doors around here locked? What's with this? Yep, I'm loving it. I'm loving it. This is good. This is really good. Actually, I'm gonna check this in. This is great. Flickering lights. They're not flickering too fast. Dungeon's all set up. You have to rub him on the carpet. Okay, in add, and then inside another file, go. Yeah. Yeah, that's totally how all header files work. You have to put him in his sock first. Yeah, Rocket Bunny here. Let me try and explain it for you a little bit, alright? So, this is how all of C works. It's a very, very basic, fundamental thing. You would go into one of your header files, alright? Pretend that we're in myheader.h, alright? You would define, it's called declaring the function or whatever. What's your function called? Int add. All right. So int add, int a, int b. Boom. There. The function is declared. All right. That's in your header file. Now in my class or whatever, my C file dot C, you can define this, right? Int. You also want to include the header though. Include myheader.h. Okay, now we're gonna not instantiate, but not declare, but we're defining this function. I think that's what it's called. You would, so then you would just go return A plus B, all right? Now another file, okay, this is your other file, .c. All you gotta do is include my header again, and then you can say whatever. Void some function, and you can use that function. Int c equals 0, d equals 5, int e equals add c d. Are you starting to understand, Rock Bunny? Maybe the max radius should decrease a little bit. Let's see, what would that do to it? Oh, you're, oh, so it feels a little bit more constricted. I could try that. Oh, there you go. Blood already did it for you. Look at that. Totally. Good example. Okay, I'm checking this in as it is, though. This is a good start. Got all these assets created for the fear dungeon. I think I can add all these. Entrance, ground, light pillar, pillar, wall, sconce, entrances and stuff. Yeah. Get at all. And we added this 9 entrance entity, the fear type of dungeon. Style cars, flickering lights started. Cool. Initial fear dungeon. Man, maybe I should start the boss right now. Let's see what it's like though, if it does constrict the light a little bit. So if an area is dark, it does always decreases the primary scale. We could just subtract from the primary scale. And that would mean that it flickers downwards, so it always is constricting the size of the light a bit. I wonder if it would have looked like with a more like dramatic though, like if it were twice as much of a flicker. Yeah, that's a bit much. Five or 10% was pretty good. 20% there was kind of a lot. Feels like it feels different. Why does that feel so much different than this? Feels like it's flickering more, but it technically shouldn't be. Oh. What is this? Is using DRAND F, which can be -1 to 1. Let's see what that looks like in a different room. Okay, I'm gonna see it again with the other. Why does that make? What it feels like that makes more difference than it should. I'm not quite thinking about it right. Oh, of course. Wait, -1 times. Oh, of course it's. Oh, yeah. So -1, that could be anywhere from -1 to. Oh, that's +1 to 1. Oh, okay, of course that's. Oh, yeah, of course. Okay, so if I wanted to actually make it always go down, I would need to go -0.05 plus 0.05 times flicker. And that would make it always constricting, but yet still only 5%. Yeah, thanks, Gashit. Thank you. Oh my god, I'm like, what? Because I was thinking flicker was 0 to 1 there, but it's actually -1 to 1, so. Duh. That's what you get for staying up late. It's what I get for staying up late. I'm always stupid the next day. Always. It's like my brain just turns off. Yes, that's nice. This flicker is much softer now. Okay, now I want to make the color scheme a little bit different. So just slightly different, more fear-ish. You can see that the atmosphere up here, the orange glow on the top of the screen, it's straight from the fire dungeon. That's the color scheme from the fire dungeon. So I want to go to an area with water. Isn't that zero flicker now? No, it's not zero. This is -1 to 1, a random value. So this just subtracts 5%, and then either subtracts or adds 5% more. Okay, so I need a room with water so I can see the water color, because the atmosphere is the same as the water color. So I want to go, it'd be nice to have some water to see. Find some water. Where are you? Hey, cool, this one worked out. I push that. Get through. Come back. Push it this way. This way. I love it when the puzzles actually work. Oh, there's some water. So, save here. Oh, there was also a puzzle bridge one. Yeah, I want to go to that puzzle bridge area. That had more water in it. Okay, watercolor. Those moving cubes, they ruin your life. Oh. Yeah, there needs to be more traps. There's not enough traps in the game yet, but yeah. Those are one kind of trap. I have plans for more kinds of traps for sure. Like a little tower thing that shoots at you and stuff. Basically entirely inspired by Zelda 1. And those head things that shoot like slow moving flickering balls of energy at you. Fear dungeon watercolor. Here we go. Water is sort of an orange color. In this old dungeon, we want to make. What should the hue? I'm thinking hue is somewhere between purple and red. Maybe just red. Yeah, maybe just red. How about halfway between? Nah, this is getting pink. I don't know about purple. I'm thinking red. Maybe reddish orange. No, reddish pink. Maybe there. guess the pink tone in that. It's like a little too pink for me. Maybe just pure red. Or like a really close to... There. That's pretty good. Karstar, car, same thing. A function could have a return type of Karstar, but return a car. Yes. No, this is getting pink. Yeah, good job, Rocket Bunny. Look at it, you won a lot. Some people have been winning like 7, 6. It kind of sucks to win that low. There we go, now it's more like blood. Sort of a bloodish color. Maybe darker. Darker and more bloody, blood-like. This was like a brightness of, let's see how low we can go. See, the more I take out brightness from this color though, it's gonna make the atmosphere color kind of disappear. So I can't take out too much dark, too much hue or value out of it. I mean, yeah, just value. Let's try 85. As in TI-85 calculator. So the water looks good, but now the atmosphere is almost gone. Yeah, we can't really take. It's there, but it's. Yeah. It takes away too much from the water. Atmosphere color. Wait, I could just force the atmosphere color to be bright. Oh my god, that's actually a pretty good idea. I'm gonna go to the atmosphere color. I don't know, you got 225 points. How do you win points? You gotta follow. You just follow. That's it. You just naturally get points. Nice, I got that joke. There you go. Now you got 255 points. You got the maximum for an 8-bit number. You're rich. You're rich. You're so rich. Atmosphere color. Where is that? It's in area. Atmosphere. Here we go. The color is C, which is the color mix of water. Okay, we want to totally amp this up. Yes, look at that. Look at that. Better than Tetris. Oh. So we're going to get the color of water into a color HSV. And then set the value to be maxed out 1. And then get the color. So there, no matter what I choose for an atmosphere color, it's gonna be bright as possible. Even if I have a dark red blood color. This incident will be reported. It's so funny, right? That we've put that kind of stuff into our Unix systems and stuff. This incident will be reported. As long as somebody checks the logs, this incident will be reported. Ooh. Ooh, check it out. Check out how the fog color got really cool from changing the water color to be dark red. Yeah, I like this. I like this dark red blood color. Yeah, good. Maxed out atmospheres. Those are sweet. Be nice if they were even brighter atmospheres. Why are they so... Nice one, Bonfu. All right, it's the gradient opacity and then the opacity. Gradient opacity, opacity. Okay, so this is 48 and 80. That's why they're not that. I think these could be pumped up a bit. Maybe this should be more like 80 to 120. Nice, he quotes BC Warrior. Yeah, that gives it more atmosphere. Huh, maybe I should do an atmosphere opacity in the data. It's kind of neat actually to see this much atmosphere. But maybe it's a little much. In this dark room, it looks over. Bearing a little bit. Looks a little bit much. It's a bit too much. Yes. I remember that one. So it was 48 to 80. Let's do 62 to 96. Yeah, that one too. That was Zilton, I think. Zilton's like, quote, 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 quote. Yep. Thanks, Zilton. Yeah, that's looking pretty good. Oh, I love these rooms with falling bombs. It's like my favorite room. So far, I haven't seen any walls that were too narrow. Okay, what if the ground had a little bit of red tinge to it as well? Also need to come up with a cool door color. Right, yeah. Support for the ecosystem. That's right. The economics of it all. How about the key color is the exact same color as the watercolor? Like, definitely not blue. As if the mods wouldn't abuse the system. Just Pedro? You here right now, Pedro? You hear this? Alright, that door is too bright. We need like More saturation. Lots more sand. All the way on the saturation. Maybe not all the way. Maybe like there. Okay, this is something I haven't tried yet. The door's the same color as water. Never! I never would, I promise. What? What? These doors look... Oh, it's because this door is locked. Do I need keys? I need a key, man. Give me a key, man. I need a key. Yeah, when it opens up, the door looks a bit more bright. Don't ban the banner, ban the game. Hunter Hunted? No? Was it a good game? I've not even heard of this game. Have you guys seen Enigmatic Man? Well, that's pretty cool. It's like Prince of Persia kind of. Looks like. Look at that. Look at this HUD. No, seriously, if you guys have not seen Enigmatic Man, this is one of the funniest games you'll ever see. Yes, yeah, I totally have. Yes, Stranger Things, so awesome. Wait, no, this is not it. Enigmatic Man, the game. Maybe this is it. Apparently this is a really horrible game. But these screenshots are not making it look very horrible. Yeah, totally. Stranger Things was dope. When I finished Stranger Things, I'm like, man, I wish Stranger Things was longer. There's only 8 episodes. So good. And yeah, it's very, very helpful and inspiring too for making a fear dungeon too. Like that first scene, the very first like 2 minutes of Stranger Things, that's totally giving me ideas for how to make the fear dungeon look cool. So great, right? Yeah. Such a good story. Such a good, everything about it's good. The soundtrack. I don't know if these doors are dark enough yet. That's what they look like. Yeah, I want them to be fully saturated and maybe not as bright. Yeah, I can't wait for Stranger Things season 2. I'm like, man, we gotta wait a year for Stranger Things season 2. I can't wait that long. Gosh, this can go even darker. Let's see what it looks like with 50%. It's like gonna be a real dark door. Hopefully. Darker, but if it's about there, it's gonna be okay. So that's about all I'm gonna really get out of that, unless I try changing the hue. Thanks, Bafu. Okay, so this color works. Let's try an experimental color. Maybe something that's a complement to this color. Play with some complementary colors here. All right, Blood. See you, man. Missed you too. Have a good one. We'll catch you next time. So, like, the exact complement of this red color would be sort of this cyan color. Or some triad colors would be like this green and this pinkish purple. I don't know if I really want to try this complement. Maybe I'll go with this straight up triad thing. Whoops. What color is that? What would that look like as a door color? It looks good. Sure, if it really fits the theme. I like seeing all this red because it really makes me think of fear and blood and stuff. The purple really doesn't really do it. Doesn't do it for me. Okay. Obligatory, gotta try the color complement. This might surprise me or something and be like, yeah, that's cool. Or maybe not. Oh, that. Wow, you can totally see that is a pretty complementary color for a door. But still, I don't like it. I don't like it. How many hours you work on the game off stream? What's up, Guru Toro? I usually work about 8 to 10 hours a day, and I work 7 days a week, just about that many hours every day. I'd stream for about 2 hours, and that means I've off stream, I'm doing about 6 to 8 hours of further development every day. And on days when I don't stream, I still try and do some videos, like YouTube videos and stuff, so... I'm always trying to get about an hour or two of video up on YouTube, even if I'm not doing a stream. Okay, so let's go back to the red color for the door. And now I'm going to play with the rock color being slightly red as well. Right now it's sort of this tan orange hue, which is pretty good, actually. This is a pretty good color to start with. But if we're just, see, it's even changing it is just barely different. But let's see what that barely different looks like. Sometimes barely different is actually a lot different. That was really good. This other color. Oh, they're the same. Hold on. Wait. 5E54, 5E53. Wow, that color was only off by that one number. That's crazy. I changed both the dirt and the rock. See, yeah, you can totally tell it changed the tone of the whole screen. Man, I liked it better with this other one. It seems crazy how much that tiny little change seemed to affect the whole whole vibe of this dungeon. It's actually a really cool color for the floor and for these rocks and stuff. Okay, cool. I'm gonna leave it there. And finally, I'm gonna play with the grass color. The grass color is used kind of infrequently. But what hue is that? Hue 174. So if I go to this, change to hue 174, make this my grass color. I think this could do pretty well. I'm not even sure if there are any grass colors to see. Wait, grass? I think grass would be used in the switch room and the boss room a little bit. Let's go find the switch room. Darker. Vast, and I still don't like it. It's not doing it for me. This whole complementary color thing might not work for that. So maybe it should be more of like an orange or yellow. But still something that complements the existing red. Holy warrior! Something more orange. I'm gonna keep this color. 8B7. Or possibly towards the pink. Actually, it might be work. That might work too. Ooh, yeah, that is better there. Okay, remember that. That's 8B7468. What about that? No. Okay, cool. All the colors are dialed in. Maybe the ground should be a tiny bit reflective. It's just stone. But what does it look like if it is? Maybe there could be as like a slight layer of slime on the ground or something. Yeah, 10% is a lot. Let's try 2%. Still a lot. Oh, this might be I might not have set this up right. I might not be able to actually change the ground's reflectivity that much. Like if I went really, really low, this probably isn't going to change anything. Yeah, it's still the same thing. Okay, never mind, never mind. That's more for the ice dungeon, maybe some, maybe a few other dungeons, but not this one. Okay, good. This is a really great start to this dungeon. Got the atmosphere fully bright, a little bit brighter than it was. Primary scale flickering, constricting style, colors. Okay, how much time do I got left today's stream? Let's see, at least a half an hour. Okay, I'm gonna go and start the boss actually. The boss for this dungeon is going to be a wall. This is totally inspired by Final Fantasy. Final Fantasy 4 or Final Fantasy 2, whatever you consider that one that came out in the United States as number 2. I think it was number 4 worldwide or whatever. But anyways, Final Fantasy 4/2 had this giant wall that you had to fight, and the wall kept getting closer and closer and closer and closer. If the wall actually reaches you, you die. So that's what I want this enemy to be, a giant wall that keeps getting closer and closer and closer to you. And if it ever comes and touches you, you die. So that's what this guy is going to be. Giant moving wall. I think it's going to be pretty intimidating. All right. So what I need is a bigger room. The last line of the file will always become the same as the line before it. Have you tried stepping through it, Rocket Bunny? This would be a really good time for you to understand how to step through your code with the debugger. So I would highly recommend this. You know, get yourself, get your Visual Studio set up so you can set a breakpoint like this. This is a breakpoint. You know, it should be, it's red in Visual Studio. And then you can, your code will stop there, and then you can watch it step through each line, and then you can figure out what's going wrong with your code by stepping through your code. So are there any bosses that are even anywhere near kind of like how this one is supposed to be? There's no giant wall boss yet. All right, so what would be the boss I could copy though that would be somewhat similar? I don't know, any one of these bosses, I guess. Let's see, we'll go to data, bosses. Yeah, I don't know. This is all the same. Acid boss. Fear boss. And I'll need to hook it up in the foes. Boss 9. And making sure that this doesn't ever place that boss in dungeon 9. Okay, so I should have this boss now, but it should be the sand snake right now first. What's good? What's up, Professional Nose? Everything's good. Everything's good except for the things that are bad, you know? Oh yeah, he's just hanging out. Sandy boss guy. Alright, cool. So we've confirmed that this guy is that guy. Now he's gotta make him so it turns into a wall as fast as possible. I need to make this room bigger. So in constants, yeah, pattern flags. For pattern boss 9, we're gonna go with min wall thickness. Maybe abs min. Absolute minimum wall thickness here. Let me write that wisdom down. Write this down. Go get a pen. What is it that Shakespeare said? There's nothing that is either good or bad, but thinking makes it so. A big wall, and I mean that's not hard. Just make a big wall really quick. I gotta count how many tiles there are though. I want this wall to be about the right size. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 13 tiles wide. And I want it to be about 6 tiles tall. So 13 times 20 is 260. And then if it's about 12 tiles times 6 is 50 tall, or 60 tall maybe. Yeah, he looks even better in the dungeon he's meant for. Yeah, that's the acid boss. His name is Murmuroth, and he's in this like sandy dungeon. It's pretty cool. I just copied that to this guy just to start this new boss. So 260 by 60 or so. I'm thinking maybe 72. 60 looked too small. There. Okay, let's get a gray wall to start with. A gray wall appears. What's up, clock? Shazzle. There we go. We have a gray wall. Now let's give it some thickness. How's life? Life is great. How's life with you, man? Yeah, life's really great here. I gotta admit, it's like, you know, I live an amazing life. I get to do exactly what I want. I'm really thankful for the risks I took that got me here. You know, if I hadn't taken the risk of risking all my time, risking all my money to try and make Songbringer and do the Kickstarter itself was a huge risk. You know, I didn't know if people would support me in this vision. I didn't know if I'd had enough big enough following to do a Kickstarter. But it all worked out, man. It got me here. And I'm really thankful for that. I'm living the life I am now because of risks I took in the past. So I'm thankful to my old self for having the courage to take those risks. And I would encourage anyone else out there to take risks as well. But make sure you're prepared for those risks. You know, don't just take risks willy-nilly. Okay, trim? Where's this trim? Trim feature, somewhere around here. Yep, totally. You are? Really? you being facetious? Or are you being serious? If you're serious, I'm excited for you. But if you're being facetious, I totally get your joke, what you're saying. That was the part I was saying about, like, you know, be prepared to take, prepare for your risks. Where the hell is the trim feature? Seriously, it's like, I know there's an image trim. Oh, there it is. Trim. Day in the life of a game developer. Don't have enough financial security? Yeah. I hear you. Oh, and the tracker for not finishing projects on your own? That also. So you know yourself well. You know yourself well enough. This is very wise of you to know yourself. And that's one of the biggest things that matters as far as game developers go is like, are you the kind of person that can finish a long project? Because if you can't, then your other choices are you could always do short projects. You know, you could do really tiny projects and just make sure you finish them. You know, something you get done in like a month or something, or a week, or a day. Right on. Thanks, man. Yeah, and people do. That's the thing that really surprised me. I didn't expect anyone to follow this game or my development of this game, but people did. So that surprised me. And all I'm saying is it might surprise you too. It might surprise you how many people would be interested in what you would create. Visual Studio's weird. What you mean? What's weird? Fear wall. Doesn't this look fearsome? Look how fearsome this monotone gray is. All right, fear wall 0. And recapal the ding ding ding. Alright, I'm gonna open up the fear boss data that just got copied over. Alright, this boss does not have a title or description yet. It's a boss. It's not the Z order split, it's Z order mid. No flip X. health. It's probably gonna have more health than that, but oh, explosion size. Okay, this is gonna be like wide, really wide. 260. Maybe less. I don't know. 260 by 70. Oh, yeah. Well, if you're on the command line, you can always use GDB. What genre of game did you make for your first indie game? My first game was in 1995. It was, I guess they call it, counts as an indie game. And that was a puzzle. It was a puzzle. It was a top-down puzzle adventure action game. Yep. Category foe. Size. This is going to be pretty important here. The size is going to be 260 by, maybe 32 deep. Maybe like 70 tall. Damage 1.0. This is like you take a lot of damage from hitting. Actually, maybe to just take maximum damage from this. Full on mass, can't move it. Speed super slow. Does have gravity. Does not have vector movement. Its idle frame is fear wall. You can always use GDB, Rocket Bunny. But it's a lot easier. Let me tell you, it's a lot easier to use Visual Studio. Unless you're awesome at the command line. This guy's gonna have a completely different behavior, so I might as well just delete all this. Yeah, most important GDB command, help. Yeah, and quit. Quit's an important one to know, too. Yeah, I'm gonna just toss all of this behavior. This is, it's gonna be totally different. So starting off, if target none, we target the main hero. Sound ambience loop. We'll set a direction south. So he starts moving south. What was the last game I played semi-seriously? I play them all serious, man. the last game I played was Hyper Light Drifter. And the game I played before that was Axiom Verge. Two of my favorite games I've ever played, actually. Both those games, amazing games. And what else? I mean, I've played a lot of NES games and Super NES games recently. You know, I've started replaying Zelda, Link to the Past. I played Zelda 1 like several times. I haven't tried any VR. I don't have any VR equipment or anything yet like that. But I've tried it at like GDB. I've tried a few VR games and a few like of these game development events that have been going on here in the Bay. There's a lot of people with VR games. Recommendations on Hyper Light Drifter? My recommendation is get it. It's awesome. But you mean like how to play it? How to kick ass at it or what? I wonder if this fear boss, it will even work. Oh, there he is. It's a giant wall, and it's moving south. Hey, that's kind of the point, right? Let's see what happens when he gets closer. Oh, no. Stop. He just stopped moving right then. Oh, just opinions? My opinions? I don't want to ruin the game or anything because it's, you know, but I would definitely have changed a few things in the way I designed a little bit of that game. Artistically, Hyper Light Drifter is freaking the bomb. I'm not even sure if any other video game in history will ever be able to make artwork as awesome as Hyper Light Drifter did. So amazing. They deserve props, like, till the end of time for how awesome of artists they are. Seriously. But game design-wise, I really thought they could have made a few choices a little bit differently. I wish there were more items and things you could do in Hyper Light Drifter. It's like, I don't want to ruin anything for anybody. And I also thought they could have hidden the map from you. They gave you the entire map, you know. So, and then it just felt like I wasn't, you know, as exploring the game, because you have the entire map, it's like, what's the point of exploring? I can see that there's like, I can get down to that little tube or whatever right there, you know. But anyways. And they might have even changed that by now. They were changing the game a lot when it first came out, which is something I don't think game developers should do. You really shouldn't be changing your game after you release it. Okay, so let's make this wall start more north. More northerly starting point. Create AI. So yeah, here we go. Yeah, I highly recommend it. I really don't think you can go wrong with that game. I mean, it's a great action RPG, and especially if you compare it to like old action RPGs of like from 20 years ago, you're kind of getting the same genre or aesthetic. Almost as a 16-bit action RPG, but it's just way better of a game than we could ever create in the 90s. You know, I mean, Zelda: Link to the Past and a lot of other action RPGs are really awesome, but like Hyper Light Drifter does put it up a notch as far as how good of a game you can make with 16-bit era style graphics and stuff, 2D graphics. What's my favorite old school game? Oh man, I was just about to say Zelda 1 because it pretty much is. Actually, yeah, I'm kind of thinking Zelda 1 is one of my favorite old school games of all time. Even above Link to the Past. I think Link to the Past is like, Link to the Past and Zelda 1 are two of my favorite games ever. And oh, and of course Super Metroid. I gotta put Super Metroid in there. Super Metroid is such an awesome game. Dude, Deer Force deserves all of the praise that they get for making Super Metroid. Super Metroid might be the best game of all time. Yep, yeah, that goes beyond my own opinion. Literally, it could be the very most best game of all time. I'm joking, of course. 50... For you, it's Link to the Past? Nice. Yeah, Link to the Past is a kick-ass game, right? We did an excellent job with that. This wall is just sitting there getting up the hall. It's like a kill thing. Oh, I can't wait to have this wall as a boss. I'm surprised I got this much done in one stream. I already got this fear dungeon kind of going and this boss kind of going. This is a lot of progress to make in one little 2-hour segment. Probably because I've done so many dungeons lately. I should be inching towards me, but it's not. I think that's because... Here, let's put it back up high so it's kind of like... eating at those walls and make it so its move mask is currently default. I think that's wrong. K filter default. See, this is totally different. This is static filter water sky foe exit shop foe. Oh, okay. This is all right. So this is what it would be if it were default. So we need to have static. So it can't move on to, actually we, shit, this doesn't really need any of this. Here, I'm gonna do this anyways, kind of have this data ready to go. But essentially this move mask for the big wall could just be none. That would allow it to move on to the player, move on to other foes in the room. Yeah, maybe other foes shouldn't. Well, it kind of depends on what other foes there are in the room. Yeah, I'm gonna start with mask none. So that means it can move on to the player or whatever. So let's say it has super duper damage. Like the second it hits you, it does 999 damage. So you just die instantly. Oh, thanks, man. Yeah, hopefully this game turns out awesome. I hope not only does it fulfill me to play it, but I want other people to really feel a good, you know, sense of excitement and like joy playing this game. It's coming for me. It's coming! Oh no! Oh! The shield? This is shield? You can just let it hit you because of your shield. Oh! Yes! This is like already kind of a fun boss fight. Wait, you can actually hurt it. I don't think you can hurt it. That's not good. It's gotta be able to be hurt. It's got a resist flag. Oh, it just doesn't have an invincible. Invincible blinks. So we need to see a few blinks when it gets hit so we can see that it's actually getting hit. Yes, this is gonna be such a sick boss battle because really it boils down to can you kill this boss in the time allotted? So obviously I'm not gonna have it be that bright. But there's no way I'm gonna kill it. Oh! Awesome! I love this guy. Alright. Now it needs a slightly different scene. Like the level that this is in here, or the screen needs to be shaped perfectly for this boss. Maybe you should crush stuff? Yeah, totally. So you just get the feeling like, oh my god, this thing is about to crush me. Okay, so yeah, starting with the shape though, the shape of this room. Area patterns. Nice. Need sleep? Yeah, totally, man. Thank you. Thank you so much. Have a good night, man. Enjoy. Thanks for stopping by. Pattern boss. Pattern boss. There we go. Boss. Wait, boss. Here we go. Boss 9 is going to be a different pattern. Fear Dungeon Boss. For now, it's going to have nothing in it. And then I'll start with bringing the walls in so that the walls of this thing horizontally are like smashed right against where this wall would be. And this, the wall moves straight down the screen the whole time. That's it. It's just a constant moving wall of death. Got enough room. I want to do these edges and stuff just right. Oh yeah, so these edges are gonna be perfect. Ship's taking some serious damage. So if you can get past the wall, this is kind of bad, because if you can get past the wall just keeps going forever. Okay, let's fill in the sides of the wall. So the edges of this screen here. So if XD is less than or equal to, what was it, 13 or 6? Oh, XD should be 6. Oh, wait. If XD is greater than 6, turn this into a wall. This does mean that this boss might need to have a guaranteed goal room that's north of here. I don't know. Or there could be sky tiles. Yeah, here we go. Now we've got kind of this one edge. What if we put some light pillars in here? So if XD is like exactly 7 and Y mod 2 is 0, maybe what mod 3? This said tile, X, Y, K tile lamp. Oh, these lamps could be in the way actually and getting crushed by the wall. That would be cool. So this is going to throw the lamps. Right in the path of the wall. Yeah, that's gotta be something, huh? Yeah, getting Jib to not pass through the wall. Yeah, I can get him some kind of like... Yeah, there's some way I could do that for sure. That will definitely be something to do with this... Maybe right behind this wall, it should all be a huge static. Oh, that's totally how it could be done. So if the wall is just one big static entity. Yeah, I'll have to work on that. Good thought. Very good thought, though. Yeah. Well, I think that's about it for today's stream. So this is going to get better and better and better. This is just an initial, totally initial, quick, rough sketch of this whole dungeon. This whole dungeon and this boss, at least they're started. There's a lot of work left to do. I love this idea of having some stuff in the way for this wall to crush on the way. But I also want to do some other kind of light in this room so that it doesn't... I don't know, I want the light to be just right. Like, there should be just enough light where you can see it, but there's just the smallest amount of light where you know, it still is intimidating and still very fear-oriented. And, of course, this wall needs to move a lot slower in general. You know, like, it needs to move slow enough that you would have enough time to actually beat it before it came all the way down. There's a couple other things too. Like, I would like it so you can actually get hit by the wall or pushed. I want you to be able to be pushed by the wall, but then it finally crushes you if it gets all the way to the end. So, and then of course, you know, Jib can't move behind it, and then drawing it, and then giving it some more attacks too. Like, it should be able to like shoot something at you or spawn some kind of enemy or something. You'd have to contend with and make it sort of a multi-dimensional fight. But this is kind of cool to see this working as it is so far. So, yep, that's it for today's stream, and I really appreciate y'all. Thanks for watching. Thanks for supporting me. Thanks for encouraging me. And I hope that I can encourage and inspire and do good things for you too. So, cheers, everybody. See you next time.